So one more very, very important question for exam point of view is the length of the longest pole. So first of all, try to imagine in your room, this is your room basically, what is the longest pole that can be fitted in? So it will be from one corner to the opposite corner. Is it making sense? That
yes,
is the
sir.
Only way it can be the longest. Just try to think of your geometry box. What will be the longest pencil that can fit in the geometry box? If I keep it like this, or if I keep it like this, or if I keep it diagonally. At times, lunch box में चम्मच fit नहीं होती. मम्मी क्या करती है? Diagonally रख देती है ना उसको. Making sense? So
yes, sir.
So basically, longest pole का यहाँ पे जो concept है वो diagonal का है. Okay. So they are actually asking you to find the diagonal of the room. And room की जो shape है वो 10-10-5. That means cuboid. So actually ये जो एक नया concept है, this concept is called diagonal of cuboid. Okay. Diagonal of cuboid. You can put the heading also. I'll show you one. So diagonal of cuboid in a 3D shape looks something like this. Can you see that? The green line. Just stop me where you find it comfortable. Is this way of looking comfortable?
Yes, sir.
Can you imagine your room like this?
Yes, sir.
So 10-10-5. So length is 10. So that means this part is 10. This part is 10. Breadth is 10. And height is 5. Making sense? Yeah. Now I need to find this green line. So first of all, I need to join this line also. Then only I will find a triangle over here. Making sense? This is 3D shape, that's why it will be difficult to imagine. So actually you need to find this green line. This is GB. You can read out the names. GB, this is D. So this is 5. I need to find this green line. Sorry, first of all, this black line, DB, this one. Before even finding out this green line, I need to find this black line. Can you help me in finding this black line? If you just pay attention, this is also a triangle. Yes? And as we know,
yes.
these might not look like right angle triangles because we are looking at some different perspective. But try to recall yourself, these are rectangles. Do you remember? So this has to be 90 degree. Making sense?
Yes, sir.
So let me just find, this is also 10, isn't it? Parallel, this becomes also 10. So I get a triangle, right angle triangle over here. This is B. This is 90C and this is D. Okay. BC is 10 and DC is 10. Can you find this one? Pythagoras theorem. DB square equals to BC square plus DC square. Is it making sense? PGT, Pythagoras theorem. N square is 100. Plus 10 square is 100. So under root of 200. What is under root of 200 value? Can I write it like this? 2 into 10 into 10? Please say yes, no.
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
Can I find How did I get the root? Do you know this thing now? DB square, and here it is DB. The square goes to the other side, it becomes root. So 10 into 10 is common. So 10 common, 10 root 2, whatever, centimeter, meter, whatever. If it is meters, right meter. So this is my DB. Okay. DB is 10 root 2. So this becomes my 10 root 2. 10 root 2. Now I can use again Pythagoras theorem over here. Okay, I'm doing it that side. Let me just use black color. So GB square equals to GD square plus DB square. Don't worry, I'll give you a shortcut formula for this also. But right now, I'm doing it a long way so that you understand the process. So GB is what? Sorry, GD is what? 5. Can I write 25? DB square, that's mean 10 root 2 square. And 10 root 2 square is nothing but 200. Isn't it? We started off from there only. No? If you don't understand, I'll help you in that also. 10 root 2 square means 10 root 2 into 10 root 2. 10 into 10, 100. Root 2 into root 2 is 200. Making sense?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that gives me a motivation that you are understanding. Okay, this is GB square, and I'll take the root over there. GB equals to 25. So the length of this green line is 25. No, not 25. Sorry, 15, I guess. 15 into 15 is 25. No? Kya ho jata hai? Making sense? Do you want a shortcut for this? Not every time you want to do a long way. If you don't, yes, I can move ahead. I don't know. Okay. So in a cuboid, okay, or a cube also, length, breadth, height, you are actually finding this line. And you are doing basically Pythagoras theorem twice, isn't it? First of all, base, and then this triangle, this one. What you need to do is basically find diagonal equals to L square plus B square plus H square. Let me just do it quickly and check whether my answer was correct or not. Length was 10 square, breadth was 10 square, height was 5 square. 100, 125. 225. Can you see that? And answer is 15. Did you find it easy now? Yes.
Yes, no? Sir.
So for the time being, this question was difficult, but I gave you this question so that we can discuss it today. And right now, this question will come for only 1 mark because the formula is easy. For you, this question will be for 3 marks because you could have done this long way. Making sense?
Yes,
you want
sir.
Me to explain once again? Or is it fine?
No, sir. Now it is clear.
Okay. So same formula will go for cube also. There it will be side square, side square, side square. Is it clear? There it will be side, 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 side square, side square, side square. So in a way, formula is same. Anyway, I'll stop over here. Please copy this thing